Hi everyone, welcome all back. In this video, we are going to see how the heat is exchanged between two surfaces in radiation mode, and we will solve some problems on heat exchange between the surfaces. So before going into the problem, we are going to see some formulas which are going to useful in solving the problem. Now consider any two surfaces like this. If this surface is at temperature T1 and this surface is at temperature T2. Now consider T1 is greater than T2. So if T1 value is greater than T2, it will emit the radiation from this in all directions. So the radiation in this direction will be absorbed by this plate because of the temperature of this plate is lesser than this plate. Okay. So in case consider T2 is greater than T1, then the radiation emits by this surface will be absorbed by the first surface, number one. This is number two surface, like this. So now consider, so first formula is heat exchange between two large parallel plate. Heat exchange between two large parallel plates. Okay, so now Q12, since I am considering surface number 1 and the surface number 2, this is Q12 equal to epsilon to the power bar sigma A into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4. Okay, now where epsilon dash equal to 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 to the bracket minus 1. This is the formula for epsilon dash. Similarly, the second formula is heat exchange between two large concentric cylinder or spheres. Heat exchange between cylinders or spheres. Okay, now the formula is Q12 is equal to epsilon bar A1 sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4. Now here epsilon value is equal to 1 divided by epsilon plus A1 divided by A2 into 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. Okay, here the A value is 2 pi RL for cylinder. Similarly, A equal to 4 pi r squared for sphere. So if you consider concentric cylinders like this, so the inner area is called as A1, the outer area is called as A2. For both A1 and A2, the formula is 2 pi r L. The R value will differ for the inner cylinder and outer cylinder. So this is the second formula. The third formula is heat transfer with n number of shields in the is given by. Heat transfer with n number of shields. Okay, this is Q1N. So number of, if you use two numbers of shields in the sense, you have to substitute Q12. So here it is equal to A into epsilon T1 power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 plus 2N divided by epsilon S minus N plus 1. Okay, here epsilon 1 is the surface emissivity, epsilon 2 is the second surface emissivity, and epsilon S is the shield emissivity. So if you have three number of shields, all three number of shields will have equal emissivity value. Okay, similarly N equal to number of shield. Okay, with all these formula we will solve the problem. So go to the first problem. So this is the first problem given. So in this problem, emissivities of two large parallel plates maintained at 800 degrees Celsius and 300 degrees Celsius are having the emissivities of 0.3 and 0.5 respectively. So now just consider two surfaces like this. So the first surface temperature T1 equal to 800 degrees Celsius. Second surface temperature T2 equal to 300 degrees Celsius. Similarly, epsilon 1 equal to 0.3 and epsilon 2 equal to 0.5 respectively. Okay, find the net radiant heat exchange between these two surfaces per square meter for 20 numbers of plates. Okay, so given data, right? Given T1 equal to 800 plus 273 Kelvin, T2 equal to 573 Kelvin, 300 plus 273, and then epsilon 1 equal to 0.3, epsilon 2 equal to 0.5. So now to find the radiant heat exchange per square meter. So Q divided by per square meter is area. So this is you have to find out for. So here for this plate. It is not 20 plates, for these plates you have to find out the Q. So now you know the formula Q1 to 2 equal to the heat exchange between surfaces epsilon dash A sigma T1 power 4 minus T2 power 4. You know the formula of epsilon dash is equal to 1 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. So substitute 1 divided by 1 divided by 0.3 plus 1 divided by 0.5 minus 1, you will get the answer as 0.23. Now Q by A equal to 0.23 into 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 into area value is 1. So because area is substituted here, area comes to this side. So that Q12 divided by A equal to 0.23 epsilon into sigma into temperature value is 1073 power 4 minus 573 power 4. Okay, you will get the answer as 15.8 into 10 to the power 3 watt per meter squared. Okay, go to the second problem. So this is my second problem here. Two large parallel plates are maintained at a temperature of 900 Kelvin and 500 Kelvin respectively. So there are two plates. This is at 900 Kelvin. This is at 500 Kelvin. Each plate has an area of 6 meter squared. So area equal to 6 meter squared. Calculate the net heat exchange between plates for the following cases. Okay. So T1 equal to 900 Kelvin, T2 equal to 500 Kelvin. Now solution case 1. The case 1, both the plates are has to be assumed as black plates. Okay, so in case of black plate, the emissivity value is nothing but 1. Okay, so case 1 is black surface. For black surface, epsilon equal to 1. So both the plates are assumed as black surface. So sigma 1 equal to sigma 2 equal to 1. Now you can find out the epsilon dash value as 1 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. So 1 by epsilon 1 is this value is 1, this value is 1. So 1 plus 1, 2 minus 1 equal to 1. So 1 divided by 1 becomes 1. So epsilon dash is equal to 1. Okay, now substitute Q12 equal to epsilon dash sigma A T1 power 4 minus T2 power 4. So here epsilon dash is 1. So 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 into area of the plate is 6 meter squared into 900 power 4 minus 500 power 4. So you will get the answer 201.9 into 10 to the power 3 watts. Okay, now go to the case 2. In the case 2, you are asked to assume that epsilon 1 equal to epsilon 2 equal to 0.5. okay, both plates having the emissivity of 0.5. so now epsilon dash equal to 1 divided by 0.5 plus 1 divided by 0.5 minus 1. okay, the final answer will be 0.33. so now find out the q12 value, 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 into 0.33 into area of the plate 6 into 900 power 4 minus 500 power 4. You will get the answer as 66.6 into 10 to the power 3 watts. So it can be written as 66.6 kilowatts. So this will be your final answer.